The French 75, a drink that dates back to World War I. Welcome to The Cocktail Spirit from Small Screen Network. I'm your host, Robert Hess. The French 75. If you do any research at all, you'll find out it was named after the 75mm cannon that we used in World War I to great effect. Now, as the story goes, it was actually a flying team from France, made up of French and American flyers, that eventually evolved into the drink we now know as the French 75. You've already seen me make this drink on the show using gin, and if you look through most recipes, you'll see it made with gin. However, there is also a cognac story associated with this drink. And as the story goes, the French, upon coming back from a successful flight, would take and toast their success with champagne. The Americans, used to the more stronger drinks like whiskey and stuff like that, wanted something a little bit more punch to it, and so instead of drinking champagne, they decided they should all drink cognac instead. After one such return, one famous French pilot decided to take and throw a couple ice cubes in his drink, in his cognac, and then top it off with champagne, and that became then the standard drink they had. Eventually, the cognac got replaced by gin and was served at the Savoy in London. Now, the name French 75, like I said, comes from the French millimeter gun. The French never would have called their gun the French 75. They just call it the 75. So the name French 75 and the use of gin is standard. But in order to take and celebrate the origins of this drink, the true origins of where this drink came from, we're going to use cognac instead. We're going to start with 1.5 ounces of cognac. I'm using Remy Martin. To that, we're going to add 3/4 ounce of lemon juice. Now again, this is not something that the French and Americans would have added there at their aerial location, because they would have had lemon juice. They just would have had the cognac and the champagne. We're also going to take and add 1 teaspoon of sugar. I'm using finely granulated bar sugar. Sometimes you'll see this mentioned as using powdered sugar. Those typically going to be European recipes. In Europe, powdered sugar was simply highly granulated regular caster sugar, where in America we're actually adding cornstarch to our powdered sugar, which can make it kind of gummy. So I'd look for the finely granulated baker sugar or caster sugar, something that's super fine that'll dissolve really well. We're now going to shake this up with ice. Then strain it into an ice-filled Collins glass. You'll sometimes see this done in a champagne flute, which is kind of the normal way of doing it these days. However, the original way would have been in something like a Collins glass. Now we're going to top this with champagne. In our case, we're going to use sparkling wine, which is essentially the same thing as champagne. Champagne is made from a specific region in France. Sparkling wine is made anywhere else. This is a nice sparkling wine, Piper Sonoma. Now, in the past, I've used champagne or sparkling wine in cocktails on the show, and I've gotten a little bit of grief from that, people complaining about the rather cavalier way I'm opening the champagne bottle. If you think about it, this is under pressure, and so a sparkling wine really can be considered a loaded weapon, and you need to be careful. Around me, all I've got is camera crew, and I don't really care about them that much, but with customers, you actually probably want to be careful about them and not shooting them in the head with a champagne cork. So let me show you the right way of opening up champagne. We're going to take and start with peeling off the top, which sometimes can be a bit of a chore, but just take your time. As long as this cage is on, you're basically safe. The moment you take the cage off, though, that's when the problems can possibly arise. You want to make sure you have a towel ready. Untwist the wire cage. Open it up to loosen, and as soon as it's off, From that point on, keep that towel around. I'm going to be holding the towel down here with my hand. Pull the cork off slowly. You don't want to pop too loudly, just kind of a light little fizz like that. And there we now have a safe open bottle of sparkling wine. Now we take our glass, top that off. If you like, you can add a couple of straws. By adding the straws, you're going to take and be aerating a bit and getting some of the champagne down to the bottom. And there you have a French 75.